This video will cover Chapter 1, Part 1. We're going to start with some basic definitions about science and biology, and we're going to move into the overall characteristics of what living things are. A few notes before we get started. You guys should be taking notes on these video lectures. A useful hint, I have the files for these presentations posted in Blackboard. You can print those out or take notes in a notebook. Either way, pretend you are sitting in a lecture class and take some notes as you go along. That'll help you remember this information so that when you take the test later, you'll actually be able to process the information and pass the exam. All right, so let's get started. So, I want you guys to think about a few questions. What is science? How does science affect your life? And where in life do you experience science? So, what is science? Science is a study of natural phenomena and what is going on in the world around us. Science affects every part of our life, from modern medicine to technology, and it's all around us. So we experience it every time we pull out a smartphone from our pockets, log into a computer, or go to the doctor. If we look at the word science, it comes from the Latin scientia, meaning knowledge. Science is a systematic and logical approach to discovering how the universe works, and it has several measurable aims. So we're going to collect data, we analyze that data, we look at observations, and this is a research-based field. Science is a vast field as well. There are many branches of science, things like chemistry, physics, biology, just to name a few. For this course, we're going to narrow science down to just the study of biology, which is a natural science. We are going to be studying life and living organisms. Biologists often study structure and function of different parts of living organisms. They look at growth, origin, and evolution, so where these organisms came from, how they got to be. Biologists look at distribution, how these organisms are spread out around the world. And to help us study all of this, we look at taxonomy, the science of naming and categorizing organisms. Biology is broken down into many branches or disciplines: agriculture, anatomy and physiology, cell biology, ecology, developmental biology, conservation biology, genetics, microbiology, botany, zoology are just a few of the disciplines within this very large category. Science is kind of like space. The universe is our largest unit, so it's like science itself. Galaxies are smaller units within the universe, so that could be like biology, chemistry, physics. The solar systems are smaller still within the galaxy, so we can look at things like the divisions of biology, agriculture, anatomy and physiology. Within each of those solar systems, there are specific planets as well. So we can break down those divisions of biology into specific units. We've said that biology is the study of life. We need to figure out what is life. What does it mean to be alive? There are six different characteristics that we're going to look at that define living organisms. There are six common characteristics to living things. The first one is organization. All organisms are made of atoms. Atoms can be organized into gases, liquids, and solids. We take those atoms and organize them into small molecules, which can be organized into larger molecules. So note that not just living things have organization. However, living things take organization to higher levels than non-living things. Cells take large macromolecules and turn them into structures such as organelles. Cells can be organized into tissues, which work together in organs to make the different processes of our body work. Many organs can be put together into an organ system, and several organ systems lead us to complex organisms. The second characteristic of life is that living things must acquire materials and energy. So, how do organisms stay organized? They need energy. To get energy, we eat food. Living things break down their food into energy, such as ATP, and building blocks like amino acids and carbohydrates and sugars that we can use to build other materials that we need. A third characteristic is maintaining an internal environment. This process is called homeostasis. For example, humans have a set point for our normal body temperature, 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. If we get too hot, we're going to respond by sweating. If we get too cold, we will shiver. And both of these processes bring our body temperature back to the set point. We maintain that internal temperature or internal environment. There are many conditions that need to stay constant depending on what kind of organism we're looking at. If we're talking about humans, body temperature, pH levels, water levels, salt levels, all need to remain constant. So, how do things remain constant? It's because organisms respond to their environment. Sweating and shivering are responses that our bodies have that help us maintain homeostasis and keep our body temperature at the set point. All living organisms respond to changes in their environment. So plants change depending on light. There are some plants that will actually change the direction of their leaves to follow the sun throughout the day. If you are interested, I've included a couple of web links for you guys to see plants in motion. Fifth characteristic all living organisms have is reproduction and development. Reproduction focuses on passing DNA on from one generation to the next. All organisms reproduce either sexually using two partners or asexually by making a clone of itself. Bacteria and hydra, the bottom two pictures, are going through asexual reproduction. Humans, plants, and other organisms go through sexual reproduction, requiring a male and female to contribute DNA to the next generation. The sixth characteristic all living organisms have are adaptations. Adaptations are modifications that make organisms suited to their way of life. These adaptations give variety to all organisms. Not all organisms are good at the same thing. For example, this hawk is adapted to a carnivorous lifestyle. It has a sharp beak that is powerful and talons that are meant to help it capture prey. These birds are swift flyers and have keen eyesight. Penguins, on the other hand, are birds that are adapted for swimming. Their wings are flipper-like, their body is torpedo-shaped to help them be hydrodynamic, and they're unable to fly. Their beaks are thick and stout because they eat fish rather than tearing into the flesh of prey. These adaptations are a result of thousands or hundreds of thousands of years of evolution. We're going to talk about that later in the semester. So far for this chapter, we've covered the definition of science and biology, and we've described the six characteristics that all living organisms have. The next parts of this module will cover the scientific method and scientific literacy.